one of my student DJ is going to tell you why weeds are really important. I hope you can understand it as well as he has understood so that you can use it in your own permaculture field. Yeah, DJ, tell me what you have learned from my PDCs.
So weeds are very important in permaculture because of three things. Firstly, they are there as a response of the soil. They are not separate from the soil. Weeds are a part of the soil and an extension of nature's response to soil. That's the first part.
Yeah, the first is the response of the soil. The second
you
is...
You want me to continue? Yeah,
you should. It'll look good. It is for your benefit.
Yeah. Thank you, teacher. Sai Prasanna Kumar. The second most important reason, important thing about weeds is that they kind of tell you what type of plants and trees are most appropriate for the season, which season they come, the weeds come, they'll suggest similar things. But at the same time, as an indicator plant, they are very good. But at the same time, they also provide the habitat and food and other things required by other species that are local. Now what happens is you have a piece of land and you clear it off with of all weeds and you just plant whatever crop you want, like tomatoes or something. What happens to all the other pollinators? What happens to all the other soil bacteria that are dependent on the weeds? They're going to die. Slowly your soil ecology depletes, your biological abundance depletes, and suddenly you'll find yourself in a very infertile and very difficult to repair system. And as a result of that, obviously nature will know that the crop you put, if it is not suitable for the land, that is, if it's not like the weeds that you have removed, at least closely, immediately say, what garbage have you put here on my skin? So it's going to send in pests to clear off your farm. Then you have to resort to all kinds of Brahmastra and that astra and this, all Mahabharata scenes you have to do to barely make a crop grow. Yeah, but keeping the weeds prevents you from that, and it also gives you the indication of what type of plants do well where on your land, and not all your farm is the same. That also can be gleaned by the type of plants you're getting. For example, if you're getting very woody weeds, that means you have a lot of hot winds. If you're getting soft weeds, you're getting you're not having that many hot winds, at least in that season. Now the most important thing, number three, weeds. The last part of why weeds are so important in permaculture and in the world in general is that all your vegetables were once weeds, and most of your fruit trees were once just like weeds. They were just natural plants. Human beings harvested some of the seeds from the weeds, the so-called weeds, even now they are called weeds, some of them, and generation after generation by selective breeding they have developed, for example, your onion. The original onion is very different. Your carrot, the original carrot is bitter, thin and white, very thin. You won't even recognize that it's carrot, it's considered a weed. And it goes on and on with so many plants. So by eradicating weeds over and over again, we lose a lot of species. We lose a lot of potential for further development. In fact, most of the weeds either have food properties or medicinal properties. I kind of don't know any one weed that has not been having a beneficial use.
Except Parthenium?
To humans. No, even for Parthenium there is use. Not just as mulch, of course. But a lot of good reasons are there for Parthenium. It's an invasive plant. So it kind of... what do you say?
Dominant.
Not really in the ecosystemic zone of India. Therefore, its benefits are not that obvious. But once you consider where it comes from and look at people's cultures there and their food habits, Parthenium, with all its possibilities, opens up for you. One of the great things about Parthenium is that it produces its own chemicals to make its seeds germinate much, much more. That's why it's so invasive. Its seeds are very, very, very fertile and they germinate really well. So you mulch with Parthenium or you make a Parthenium tea and use that, you can increase the germination rates of your seeds. Wait a minute here. I was mentioning about mulching with Parthenium and taking aqueous extract of Parthenium and putting it on your plant and stuff.
Just thought we need to add a little bit of it while walking through the city now to keep the video up to our usually better than normal standards, you know. My videos are better standard than his, but...
Yeah, exactly. It's all subjective.
So, many studies show that actually Parthenium inhibits germination, especially when you use the leaves as mulch. It inhibits a lot of growth of other plants. So, you can use it to control weeds, for example, on your edges of your garden and other places. So, keep on rocking, keep on, you know, keeping it in your mind, right? Let's turn this way. Keep on keeping it in your mind, and don't just because the Sai's video has this or DJ's video has this, don't dump Parthenium.
Exactly.
You can.
Exactly.
Right? So, you can, the leaf of Parthenium generally tends to decrease the germination rate of so many things. But the seeds of Parthenium, when done in a proper extract and at proper concentration, has shown to improve the germination yields. It's a 8% aqueous heat extract, right? You have to do it in a particular way to take advantage of that. Just want to mention that.
Mention that, yeah. Because while we were going through the video, we and I put an annotation also, but then DJ was saying that most people turn annotations off, and which is so true, because even I don't. I find annotations very irritating coming in between the video. So we thought, why not just take a small clip and add it to that. Yeah. And yesterday and today, both are DJ's birthday, so I'm not losing out on that gift of mine.
Yeah. So just wanted to mention that. So keep your eyes and ears open for good knowledge. Oh, and one other thing. You compost Parthenium and use it, like properly composted. It's just brilliant, awesome. And there is a special composting that is even more beneficial for that is using millipedes. It's called millicompost. But more on that, you study that, right? We are experts in that, so we'll teach that sometime else.
Probably in a PDC.
That's a thorny weed. There you go. That's a fence plant for you, or it's a protection for your trees from monkeys. So everything has a use, depends on how you see it. So don't just take off. I have weed corridors all around my property, all around my farm here. As you can see, I'm walking on the edge of my property with the beautiful, my palm trees. I love my palm trees. I'm not cutting all those leaves. Maybe for one or two trees this year, we'll cut off the leaves and harvest the palms. But all underneath it, if you can look at this, you know what this is? This is Passiflora. It's a passion fruit type of an invasive creeper kind of a weed. Produces beautiful flowers, tons and tons of flowers, great attractor for beneficial insects. And it produces this fruit. You can see the abundance of fruit, right? So many fruit on this. That's a medicinal plant in itself. Now, one of the things I can do, this is one more kind of a use, just throwing it out for you guys, is that you probably know that grapes are not from India. They don't belong in India, and you know how they grow it? They grow grapes by grafting the grape plant onto a rootstock plant. Rootstock produces inedible berries. It's a medicinal plant in homeopathy and Ayurveda. But it is grafted, right? It's the same species, so same kind of a thing. So they graft grapes onto rootstocks to make them grow in Hyderabad and basically in India, and that produce rock solid world famous grapes right there. So I can probably think of some way of hybridizing or grafting and experimenting and having fun with some passion fruit and these medicinal plants. Maybe grafting is a good idea, and we'll see how it goes. So things like that, the mulch, the life, the windbreak they provide, the cover to the soil they provide, and all those things. So weeds basically are very good if you know how to use them. They are a pain in the butt if you don't know how to use them or identify and recognize what they are for what they are. So that's basically about weeds. There are two more points which will take a long time to discuss. Not sufficient on this video, probably in a PDC. I'll teach you two more rather interesting and intriguing things about
various types of weeds you can find. That's about it.
So as you can see, when you attend my PDC, you get this kind of a knowledge. And not just that, if you attend my PDC and you start teaching your PDC, you get even more better ideas. Of course, they all come down from me, and that's how you realize it. That's how any education is so is given to a student. They realize it as their own, but basically it's all that I have
done. I'll tell you what. What is the education system these days? Your parents told you to get educated well.
I think DJ is going a bit off topic. He has this tendency. But no, that is not something which you get from my PDC. That is what you come to my PDC with. So definitely join my PDC, and if you can't make it to that, you can. I mean, there's no harm in joining his PDC also. Of course, you might not get the same kind of experience and a very different experience, so to say. But see, there are different types of teachers, and as permaculturists, we don't compete. So you can join his PDC, maybe at a bit subsidized rate. Do ask for discounts. There's no harm in that.
Oh, do join Sai's PDC if you want timings and things like that.
Yeah, see, my PDC is structured. Like, see, my PDC is structured. Yeah. It is very people-centric. See, most of your traditional medicines are people-centric. It's only allopathy which tries to impose a pattern, when pattern is is something for which you should join my PDC. And I just forgot to show that this is the excellent patch that we have here. And we've made some great videos here.
And experiments. Successful, all of them.
Yes. Yeah. And it is not that hard. Permaculture is not that hard. Don't try to complicate it. And
I'm throwing seeds while I'm talking.
And definitely, do get into permaculture. Try understanding it. Try promoting it. You can see how much fun we are having. That's what permaculture is.
Yeah.
So, thanks for watching, and this is my channel, and frequently I will have some or the other, I mean, can't really call them guests because they are students, but occasionally you will have some people coming over to my show. So this is the first episode of Walk the Talk with Sai, okay?
Yes, boss.
Walk the Talk with Sai, episode 1. Okay, I'm not sure whether I'm going to release this or not, but whenever it releases, remember, it's the episode 1, okay? Thanks for watching, and definitely don't forget to subscribe. And I keep on forget telling you that, do hit the like button also. Thank you.